The first step for adding or subtracting radicals is to simplify the radicals. Then once they're simplified, we can identify the like radicals and then add or subtract the like radicals by adding or subtracting the coefficients. So for our example, the first step is to simplify the square root of 50x to the fifth and the square root of 18x to the fifth. And because these are square roots, we want to identify the perfect square factors. So for the square root of 50x to the fifth, if we recognize that 25 is a perfect square factor of 50, and 9 is a perfect square factor of 18, this can save us some time, but we can also list the prime factorizations to help determine the perfect square factors, which is what we'll do here. So let's find the prime factorization of 50. 50 is equal to 5 times 10, 5 is prime, and 10 is equal to 5 times 2, both of these are prime. So we can write this first term as negative 2 times the square root, and then for 50 we'll have 2 times 5 times 5. And then for x to the fifth, since we're looking for groups of two equal factors, we'll write x to the fifth as x to the second times x to the second times x. Notice how we have 5 factors of x, but x squared would be a perfect square factor. And then for the second term, for the prime factorization of 18, we would have 3 times 6, 3 is prime, and 3 times 2, both prime. So 18 is equal to 2 times 3 times 3. And then again for x to the fifth, we'll write this as x to the second times x to the second times x. And again, because we have square roots, we're looking for groups of two equal factors. Here's a perfect square factor, here's a perfect square factor, and here's a perfect square factor. And then for the second term, here's a perfect square factor, as well as here and here. So the circled factors will simplify. The factors not simplified will not simplify. So for this first term, we'll have negative 2 times, and the square root of 5 times 5, or the square root of 5 squared would be 5. So each group will simplify to one factor outside the square root. So we'll also have a factor of x from this group, and a factor of x from this group. And then we're still left with the square root of 2x plus 5 times, this would simplify to a factor of 3, a factor of x from this group, and a factor of x from this group. And we still have the square root of 2x. So this first term is negative 10x squared times the square root of 2x plus, this would be 15x squared, square root 2x. Notice how both terms contain a factor of the square root of 2x. They're both square roots, so the indexes are both 2, and both radicands are 2x, which means these are like radicals, so we can add them by adding the coefficients. And since negative 10x squared plus 15x squared would be 5x squared, the sum is equal to 5x squared times the square root of 2x. Notice when adding like radicals, the radical part does not change. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.